What is a funnel ladder and why do you need it? Stay tuned. A funnel ladder, or some people might call it a value ladder, is the step-by-step process of how you convert a potential customer to a raving fan. Another way to say this is how you can build a relationship with your customer. Great, I'm glad you asked. Why don't we talk about a love relationship? A love relationship is broken down by a few steps. So step one, you go and you meet someone on a blind date. Maybe you met on Coffee Meets Bagel or eHarmony or something, and you go and you meet for the very first time. So then step two, you become friends. You start to know them. You start to ask questions. Where did you grow up? What high school did you go to? What was your major in college? Where do you work? All these things, as you start to get to know them, that's the next step of your love relationship, right? So what comes after that? Then the next step is you become a dating relationship, right? Maybe you had that moment where one person said to the other, will you be my girlfriend? Will you be my boyfriend? I know I was really big on that. I don't know if people nowadays are into stuff like that, but regardless, you are now dating. And why would you date? Because you like each other. At this point, you've gotten to know facts and bits and things about each other, and now you can honestly say, I kind of like this person, and so I'd like to date them exclusively, right? And then the next step is what? Marriage. And when you are about to marry someone, you now trust that person, right? And so you don't base it on how you feel and if they like what you do and, you know, some of these things. Those are the friends. Those are your girlfriend, your guy friends. But the person you marry is someone you trust, someone you know that they'll have your back no matter what. Someone you know that when times are tough, they'll be next to you. So if you keep that in mind, that same process of moving from having just met each other on Coffee Meets Bagel to getting married and walking down the wedding aisle, that's the process of turning someone from a new prospect all the way to a raving fan. And that's how you're building a relationship with them. So let's talk about this in a business context. And we'll look into a brick and mortar business as an example. Let's just say I own a gym. Maybe I own a CrossFit. And so one of the things that I would do is that when I first meet someone, I would offer something for free. I would give value up front. So that way they will take the time to try to get to know me, bringing them to the next step. Because again, you're not trying to jump from let's meet someone and get married. You know, that's not how marketing works. You really need to go step by step up a funnel ladder or a value ladder. And so first I would offer a free 2-week trial. Come check out our gym. Come check out our equipment, our dumbbells or those things that you have. You could tell how much I work out. So those are the things that you would try to share with them when they walk in the door. You kind of build that relationship. So let's just say they kind of like you. And so then you offer them that next step. You're now trying to get to know them. So you encourage them, hey, we've got a very low introductory monthly rate for new people who sign up. And these are all hypothetical because there's no CrossFit that charges $10 a month. But let's just say for this example, we're gonna go with $10 a month. Join our gym, $10 a month, small step to get to know the gym even more. I'm thinking, okay, or as a customer, you're thinking, okay, that's a no-brainer. Let's go ahead and do that. You are on a monthly membership. Now, as a gym owner, what would I wanna do? I'm going to move them from no to like. How am I gonna do that? I wanna offer something, and let's just say for $100, join our upcoming challenge. Get to know some people in your community. Get to know the people in the gym. Cheer each other on. Compete against each other. You know, these are the things that really bring people together. And so I would build the like using programs like that and to bring them up to the next step of the ladder. At this point, people now know you, they like you, The last one is trust. So the last step of this particular funnel ladder, I would say, hey, why don't you offer a $1,000 one-on-one coaching program or $1,000 nutrition plan, 6-month nutrition plan. These are amazing products to be able to sell at the high end now because you now have their trust. And at this point, they're saying, you know what? Ever since I've joined your gym, I've been able to exercise, drink a lot of water, eat right. I've been motivated. You've been encouraging. I'm all in. I completely trust in your method of how you teach fitness, teach nutrition, teach health. I'm all in. Let's join that program. And that's how you bring people up the funnel ladder. I want to dive into one other example. So maybe you don't have an actual brick and mortar business. Maybe you sell something online. Maybe you're a coach or a consultant. So here's another example of a funnel ladder for people in this space. Let's just say I'm a mom. I have a whole process and curriculum of how to do homeschooling for your kids. So I know how to teach other moms how to make homeschooling easy. I'm sure we are all in the place where we can all relate to this with everything happening right now with the quarantine. So as a professional who wants to help and educate other moms on how to more easily homeschool their kids, my first step would be to offer a tip. Offer a tip so that the mom has a win. I help them to make it easy to get a win so that they understand that homeschooling may not be as daunting as they might feel. So then what's the next step? Well, I want them to get to know. So then they're hopefully with the win, they now want to get to know me. So then I offer a mini course. By offering a mini course, now they have a more in-depth tip, like an even bigger tip that's going to get them an even bigger win. The next step after that is to like. When they get to the place of like, they're now going to want to get to know me even more. And so this is where I would offer my full course. This could be my $100 course. And by doing that, now they're really ingrained in my techniques and all the things I have to share about homeschooling. And then what can come after that? Well, then we've built the trust. And so by this time, if I offer a mastermind, if I offer some one-on-one coaching at $1,000, they would be all in. They've now had a taste of what it's like to work with me, and they've moved up the know, like, and trust steps of this funnel ladder. And that's how this can be used for your business. So the importance of having a funnel ladder is that you are able to pre-plan all the services and products that your business can offer. And by having the higher end products and services, you now have a better return on your investment when you start your marketing. And so it's really important. A lot of people just start off with one product, one service, and they just stay there. But if you stop and actually plan out your funnel ladder and you have those higher end, even if you don't have anyone in there, I know you're probably thinking, who would pay $1,000 for a blank? Well, if you never have one to begin with, they'll never be able to. So it's good to just have one there, even if you don't have one in that package or in that service. And you'll be surprised when something now exists, there's a higher chance that there will be someone in that program at some point in the future. So I highly recommend you take a look at all the products and services your business currently offers. See if you can fit those products and services into a funnel ladder. I have a template that you can download. Just click on the link below, and I want to give you this template so that you can just fill in your funnel ladder for your business. Thanks for listening.